not thy peace, but my tears. For I am a stranger with thee, and a sojourner, as all my fathers were. Oh, spare me a little, that I may recover my strength before I go hence and be no more sin. Lord, thou hast been our refuge from one generation to another. Before the mountains were brought forth, ever the earth and the world were made, thou art God from everlasting and world without end. Thou turnest man to destruction. Again thou sayest, come again, ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday. Seeing that is past as a watch in the night. As soon as thou scatterest them, they are even as asleep and fade away suddenly like the grass. In the morning it is green and groweth up, but in the evening it is cut down, dried up and withered. We consume away in thy displeasure and are afraid at thy wrath or indignation. Thou hast set our misdeeds before thee and our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For when thou art angry, all our days are gone. We bring our years to an end as a great tale that is told. The days of our age are 80 years. And though men be so strong that they come to 80 years, yet is their strength thin, but labor and sorrow so soon passeth it away, and we are gone. So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Mighty God we serve. He's a loving God. We can never say that he doesn't know how we feel. He knows everything. And we can take all of our concerns to him. And he will love on us like never before. The Lord is our strength. He's our hope. He is our God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm about to get happy. And get started up too. Can I get somebody here to say amen? Amen. Amen. Know how much we care. We're going through this season. Hallelujah. We're going to be back at 2 o'clock. And we might continue on with the celebration.
Yes, Lord.
And the praise and worship.
Yes.
Of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 And amen.
Can you only imagine Can you imagine just standing before the king? Oh, I can only imagine what it would be like when I walk by your side. I could only imagine, yeah, what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. I could only imagine to be surrounded by your glory. What will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all of you be still? Will I stand in your presence? To my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak it all? I could only imagine, yeah, I could only imagine. I could only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I could only imagine when all I will do is forever worship you. I could only imagine, mm-hmm. I could only imagine to be surrounded by your glory. What will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus? Or in all you be still?
Young people, there's nothing wrong with dancing for Jesus. But we can't forget where we come from. So if you don't mind, let's have a little church right now.
Something about that name.
Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Listen.
Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name Jesus.
Something about the name Jesus.
Hallelujah. Yes,
yes,
sir.
It is the sweetest,
sweetest
name.
Sweetest, sweetest name I know.
Come on and lift your hands and say it with me.
It is the sweetest name.
Thank you, Jesus.
I know.
Listen to this right here.
Some people say I'm crazy, but I can't explain.
No, no.
The power that I feel, when I call your name.
When I call your name.
Said it's just like fire. Oh, oh, shut up in my bones.
Oh,
hey, the Holy Ghost is moving here.
Yes, it is.
And it just won't leave me alone. Oh, there's something. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Something about the name Jesus.
Yes, it is.
Something about the name Jesus.
Oh, I realize.
It is the sweetest name.
Oh,
I know.
I gotta be honest with you. I love.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
I love the name.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
Hey, it's the sweetest name.
Yes, it
is. Oh, yeah.
The sweetest name.
Yes, it is.
I know.
Listen. Said it's sweet. You can go on, shout, praise him, do it now. Oh, 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 yeah, 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 yeah.
Something about the name Jesus.
Oh, oh, oh.
Something about the name Jesus. It is the sweetest name.
Oh, yeah.
I know.
Thank you. Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Can we say amen?
Amen.
Can we get upon that?
Amen.
You can give him the highest praise. Hallelujah. Open to me. Open to me. Hallelujah. Lord. To say that we weren't up on each other, we weren't close like that. But when we came in the presence of each other,
yes,
he always respected me, and I pray that he would be able to say that I respected him.
Amen.
Richard was kind of funny. Amen. Amen. To look at him, you would think he wouldn't be saying nothing funny, but just hang around 2 minutes. His observations were unusual. He was different in the way that he saw things. We needed him in our family.
Amen.
We needed him in our church.
Amen.
We needed him
Amen.
To be a part of our life. Amen.
Amen.
As we go forward with this program, I pray that all of you will be able to stay focused and remember that this is not about bringing him back. Richard wouldn't come back if he had a chance. But this is about us remembering.
Yes.
We too.
Yes.
We gonna go up one day too.
Yes.
And we can celebrate and know that this is good news.
Yes.
Good news.
Yes.
That Jesus.
Yes.
Oh, I don't want to get him a sermon too quick, but Jesus.
Yes.
Somebody call his name. Jesus.
Yes.
Yeah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. I'm gonna say this and I'm going to try to sit down. Because of us that know the Lord is our Savior, and we know the rest of the story after this, we can look at things differently than the world. My daughter that lives in Colorado was called by a company. She's a registered nurse, but she has her own business in Colorado. She's caring, home care business. And she got a call from a company and asked her if she would consider taking on a contract to go to Texas and minister to the COVID patients. And when Davina called me and told me, I said, did you tell them no, you're not going? She said, Mama, y'all taught us that if we can be a blessing, we're going to be a blessing. And she said, y'all taught us, and we listened to the teaching. She said, it is well with my soul. She said, if I should die from COVID, I'm going to heaven. But she said, if I should live, I'm going to make a whole lot of money. Must run in the blood. At this time, we're going to ask for a musical selection coming from Ms. Lori Lawson, Say the Name, and then we'll come back and acknowledge the
say the name of Jesus. Say the name. no other name I know. Say the name of Jesus. Say the name of Jesus. Say the name. So precious, no other name I know that can calm your fears and dry your tears and wipe away your pain. When you don't know what else to pray, and you can't find the words to say, just say the name. Say the name of Jesus. Say the name of Jesus. Say the name. So precious, no other name I know that can calm your fears and dry your tears and wipe away your pain. When you don't know what to pray, and you can't find the words to say, just say the name. Oh, Jesus. There's no other name greater than yours. Jesus, He's the great I am. Jesus, the sustainer of my mind. When you don't know what else to pray,
to say to all the clergy that we look for you to minister and serve even after this service is over. We all need prayer, need words of encouragement and support. Amen.
Amen.
Let's thank God for our clergy.
Amen.
Our scripture reading will be coming forth at this time, Old Testament reading from Pastor Dr. Zandra Penix. New Testament, Minister Sandra Penix. Prayer of Comfort, Pastor Thomas Penix, Jr. It must be something about penises. They all over the place. Amen. And following the prayer of comfort, we have another selection, the Lord's Prayer by Miss Angela Penis.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. And he's greatly to be praised.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We have a lot to give God praise for.
Yes.
We have a lot to be thankful for.
Yes.
For one thing, we know that our uncle was saved.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. 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 We will see him again.
Yes. Hallelujah.
We will see him again.
Yes. Yes.
Hallelujah. Jesus. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Uncle Richard was rare.
Yes.
He was caring. He was sweet. I've shared with my husband for the past 20 years. I always tell him, I say, you know, I said, Uncle Richard, I've been calling him Uncle Richard because he's had so many of his mannerisms, his sarcasm.
Yes.
He got a smart mouth, just like Uncle Richard. Different things he does. It just reminded me of him, and I would call him that all the time. Uncle Richard, he was so caring and kind to me. I've always been his niece, just his niece. Although when we first got married, he told me that he had already lined up a Caucasian blonde woman for him to marry. And that was his way of joking. And, you know, later when I dyed my hair blonde, he kind of backed up off me a little bit. And think about that until the other day. I said, see why I dyed my hair blonde? But he was an awesome uncle, and we're going to miss him. We're going to miss him dearly. I want to share an encouraging word from the Word. And it's Psalm 61, and it says, hear my cry, O God. Attend unto my prayer. From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock.
Amen.
That rock is Jesus, that is higher than I. For thou hast been a shelter for me and a strong tower from the enemy. I will abide in thy tabernacle forever. I will trust in the covert of thy wings. Selah. For thou, O God, hast heard my vows. Thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name. Because of this, Lord, we know, and because of his salvation, we know that he's all right. God has given him the heritage of those that fear the name of the Lord. The word of the Lord is all we bless.
Amen.
Amen. Richard, this is a hard one right here.
Amen.
I just want to share something with his wife and the children, Eric, Tina, Vine, and grandchildren. I remember I was living in East Orange, New Jersey, going to school up there. And I was sitting on the stoop one day out there, and like, I'm lonely, I'm sad. What to put that door at home? And I just sit there and I look. And I saw this figure coming down the street. It's about a block away at that time. And I'm looking at this figure coming down. And I'm looking. Got closer and closer. I said, that's Richard. I got up and I started running towards Richard. Richard had worked his way all the way from West Point, New York, buses and trains, but he found 65 South Arlington Avenue.
And his sister said, nothing. He said, what you crying for? I said, I'm so glad to see you, Richard. I'm so glad to see you. And he said, well, quit crying. Stop. And I can still see this big old smile on his face laughing at me. And I'm crying and he laughing at me. But Richard was a gentle giant. He was a protector. He really looked out for the ones behind him. His sisters, he would look out for you. He was a protector. He was a gentle giant. I loved him. And we had the best time in Jersey. And when he left, I just cried my eyes out because I just said, well, I wish I could just go home, but there was something up there waiting for me, and I had to find whatever it was. I just wanted to share that with y'all. Richard was an awesome, awesome husband. By that time, Richard wasn't, but maybe he was, I don't know how many years older than me, but I know I was 20, just turned 20. He didn't have one. When I got back to the Carolinas and met his wife, I'm just like, wow. Wow. With this little girl. And then here's America. I thought it was the beautifulest thing. I said, wow, Richard. Okay. All right, brother. I'll be coming to you from St. John 14, verse 12, chapter 13, 14, verse. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have not told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Where I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Richard has entered into eternal life, into the arms of Jesus. One thing I do know, Richard was a saved, praying, sanctified man. His wife would tell me, Richard prays all the time. Richard prays all the time. And I know Richard made it home.
Yes.
And for this, God, we just give you the glory and the honor. But you all got to get ready because we got to go.
Yes.
And we, he will receive us into his kingdom. Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
God is good, isn't it?
Yes.
What a mighty God that we serve.
Yes.
I can say a whole lot about my uncle.
Yes.
But we've been trained right by a bishop. Do what you're supposed to do. Sit down. But I will say this one thing. As we was growing up, I always wondered about that tattoo on Uncle Richard's shoulder. And I always wanted one, but I thought, man, that thing got to hurt. And I didn't know if I should get one. I didn't know who I should put on there. And I said, well, I don't want to be getting no trouble later on, so I just better keep it clean. But he always had, growing up, he would have pork rinds. People would eat fat back. I don't know some of the stuff they say, but I saw them and I started doing the same thing. My dad said, boy, you said just like your uncle in the car. Wear out the season. I don't know. I know one, you know, when I was growing up, I was playing ball in some Reedsville, you know. For some reason, him and my dad talking, they had a big plan. He said, you know, go and stay with your uncle, you can go to Delhi. I don't know why he wanted me to go to the Panther Land. I don't know. I don't know, but the thing about it, he was willing to accept me if I made the choice. That's what type of man he was. He will give you the shirt off his back. He was there for you if you needed him. He always has something smart to say. He gave everybody nicknames. Lord have mercy. And as y'all realize and see what my wife said, I give everybody nicknames myself. Man, I'm gonna miss it, man. You know, as he went through his trials and tribulations, and he would still come in here in his wheelchair when it was time for him to come in. He would throw up that long run. Let's give God praise. Uncle Richard didn't have to say much until he was ready to say something. Mind me of myself a little bit. But man, I'm gonna miss that thing. Oh man. But you know what? He got the victory.
Yes.
We who believe on Jesus Christ, we got the victory.
Yes.
I know it seems like this is the end. I know it seems like the enemy thinks he has won and death got the victory, but death doesn't have the victory.
Oh, no.
Because it happened one day before him and his enemies could blow off the candles that the cake they baked. The ground got to shaking. And it got the earth got to moving. And it said that he got up. Oh, before they had an all night party.
Oh, yeah.
And they was ready to blow the candles out, but before they could blow those candles out, he got up. So let me tell y'all something. If you don't know Jesus, get to know Jesus. Because we all want to come this way. You know, these are the light afflictions. And he said, if you see it, it's temporal. But if you can't see it, it's eternal. Richard is seeing eternity right now. And that eternity is heaven. Man, I'm here supposed to do the part of comfort. So let us pray. Most gracious Father, in the mighty name of your Son Jesus, dear Lord, we thank you, we praise you, we glorify your holy and righteous name. You are Lord and you are God. Besides thee, there is no other. And Father God, at this time we lift up this family to the Penix Pace family and all the branches that's offered. We ask you, Father God, to wrap your arms around this wife, Armanda, wrapping around Tina, Erica, Brian, the grandchildren, wrapping around that brother, that sister, Lord, that Arthur, that aunt, dear Lord, that niece, that nephew. Oh, Father God, we ask you just to comfort us like only you can. You are our comforter, you are our peace, Father God. You are our strength, Father God. You hold us in the late midnight hours, Father God. You catch every tear that falls from our eyes, dear Lord. But Father God, we got hope. Because we know that this is not the end. Our hope is in you, Jesus. We know, Father God, that you're going to bring us through this time, Father God. Because you said these little light afflictions are just for a moment. So, Father God, as we go forth from this day on, let us lean and depend on you, Father God, for you are our strength. Help us to draw to you because you are the rock that's higher than I. Because, Father God, you have prepared a place for us that was not made with man's hands. And we say thank you, Father God. Dear Lord, we ask you to strengthen our bishop, dear Lord, as she goes forth and bring forth this eulogy. Give her the insight that she needs, Father God. Speak to her, Father God. Strengthen her, Father God. In the name of Jesus. Dear Lord, we thank you, we praise you, we glorify you, we magnify your holy and righteous name. And we're going to draw ourselves to you. For you are our strength. You are our way maker. You are our redeemer. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, let everybody say amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. He's got
thank you, Lord.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our debts as we forgive our debts. And lead us not unto temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the
just present some acknowledgement and some cards. The program said Genesty, but to my Uncle Richard, I was sharp. Box Baby and Apple didn't introduce themselves. Just as the sun will set and rise with each and every dawn, the souls of those who lived that life will eternally lives on. Now that the sun has seemed to set on someone so very dear, please know a soul who lived the soul well remains forever near. With heartfelt sympathy, Bowl Springs Baptist Church, Pastor Samuel Skills, Jr. Amen. With deepest sympathy, as you remember your loved one, hope you'll find comfort in all the good times you shared and in the memories that live on. Love, Cara. Your husband will always be with you. He'll forever be a part of you, and the love you shared will live on. Sending you love and warm thoughts in this difficult time. Love, Jody. With heartfelt sympathy during the loss of your loved one, wishing you peace to bring comfort, courage to face the days ahead, and loving memories forever for you to hold in your heart. We hope it brings you comfort in knowing that their life touched so many, for they are remembered,
with joy and gratitude, Booker T. Washington High School, class of 1966. The Lord is close to all who call on Him. As you walk through this time of loss, may you know that the Lord walks with you and He will comfort you. Love, Sharon. Remembering your husband, may the support of friends and family help ease the burden of your loss. In times, may loving memories be a source of comfort and peace. Love from Sister Brent and Brother Rick. A heavenly homecoming. Hope you'll find comfort in knowing that the one you love so much is peacefully at rest with God. Love Aunt Louise and Uncle Thomas and family. Thinking of you and the loss of your husband, moments together are never forgotten. They are forever remembered in our hearts. He lived a full and happy life. Although he is no longer with us, rich, warm memories of all that he meant to you will one day be a source of comfort. Until then, may it help you to know that many are holding you close in their thoughts and remembering him with love. Love, Barbara and John. Remembering your loved one, so special, so loved, so warmly remembered, thinking of you and wishing you beautiful memories and gentle peace. Love the Williams family. Praying you'll be comforted with precious memories and God's presence to care for you and your loss. Love, Nico. Promises of God's comfort and hope. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who loves and lives and believes in me will never die. May God's hope-filled promises bring comfort to your soul and peace to your heart with heartfelt sympathy. On behalf of the family, I would like to say thank you for all of your cards, your calls, and your kind gifts. We thank you.
Amen. Well, our program, it says that there will be reflections and remarks given, and it says 2 minutes. If you don't read it carefully, you'll think that Thomas Penix and Jimmy Hopkins and Dorothy Preston and Harold Penix could do all this. All of them combined will only take up 2 minutes combined. And I believe it's saying that they have individually 2 minutes. You think that's what it's saying? And since it is spread out like that, I want y'all to be sensitive to the fact that I've got to bring a message, and y'all know I'm long-winded, and we want to make sure that everyone is still awake when I get up. So at this time, we're going to ask Mr. Thomas Penix Sr., Mr. Jimmy Hopkins, Ms. Dorothy Preston, Mr. Harold Penix, and there's one more to add to the list, Minister Sandra Penix, to come at this time to have remarks and reflections, 2 minutes per person. Following them will be a poem by Ms. Tasha Pace. Amen?
Amen.
Thomas Penix Sr., Jimmy Hopkins, Dorothy Preston, Harold Penix, and Sandra, Minister Sandra Penix. And y'all come speak individually together, but come on. Y'all welcome to come here, stand wherever you come.
First, giving honor to God, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and the little ones that came up. He had me in my room pocket. Cause see, just like this. That was my big brother. Richard was my big brother. So therefore, a lot of things that had to get done was always put on Richard Thomas. He said, "I don't care what you do later on, but once you get things done right here, you can do what you want to do." Mm-hmm. And that's what Daddy did. And there wasn't a whole lot of debate on it. We had to do it. And we had to do it right. But, you know, I think back to the time that we got started right on that Red Hill over there on Hall River County Creek Community. That's where we started at, and here we are now. We pretty much didn't change full circle. I lost one of my brothers. That was the number one right there, to tell the truth. But we had to do so much together. You know, we had to see that we got done. And because she didn't want to do no night work. She didn't get it done in the daytime, she had to do it at night. We couldn't do that. And we said, we ain't gonna go out like that. So we went on and manned up and got it done. But when it got all started, I'm gonna try to stay inside for 2 minutes, but I feel like I'm already a minute and a half. So when we got started, you know, we got started right here. But I'm gonna tell you, we got started right back there in the Stucco Church. And by getting started right there, you come full circle again. I remember the evening, or that morning, when Richard and I gave ourselves to the Lord in the Stucco Church. And then from the Stucco Church to Troublesome Creek. But we didn't have no pool back then. That's right. We had Troublesome Creek. Yeah, all of us right there were on the devil. And you know what? Trouble time. And I know, and y'all probably didn't see it, but I know it's a big moccasin in that. But when you do it, oh Lord, this big moccasin in that. To the deck, someone wrong over the line. I'm not kidding. No, but the thing about the world, when them three brothers, Bishop Moe started chanting down at that creek. Them snakes had to go up the hill, go up the creek, and stay down the creek. But they couldn't come out. Nowhere in the world they could come out, because I know what happened down there at Troublesome Creek. Me and Richard Doris and they were afraid, but I'm not for sure. The wall was built right there at Troublesome Creek. A lot of things that happened at Troublesome Creek. But that was the best thing that ever happened. Because it changed my life. So, you know, to say again, we're coming full circle. He's my big brother. And now, at this church, he's going out at this church on his home door. So, you know, it's pretty much full circle. But I wasn't ready for him to go, but I don't make that decision. My Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, makes those decisions. And he seen it was time for Big Rich take his final flight, and yeah, I did. So it's like this right here. And every night, some rain must fall. But that rain just don't stay there. That rain goes back to the fall. Every bit. It ran, part of the hill ran down Troublesome and on out to the Atlantic Ocean. So he's out of this life, out of this body. But he's not gone, because he's right there in the center of my chest right now. That's why I got filled up right now. Because we did so much together. Made it happen. Covered some ground. Serious ground. It wasn't no problem, but 9 times out of 10, I'm going to be on the right, Rich going to be on the left, he's the vice versa. He's on that and I'm on the right. That's just the way it was. That's what we set up. We carried through. So, but otherwise, to all family members and the loved one that came out to give my brother his farewell. Thank y'all very much. Thank you very much.
To God be the glory. Just a few words. First of all, I want to say thank you, Lauren. but you were a wonderful son, a wonderful wife. We don't even consider you as a sister-in-law, we consider you as a wife. You were so, so faithful beside me. We have nothing but accolades for you. We thank you so much. Amen. When you saw, when you took those vows, one thing I do believe, you meant it from your heart because you have showed us to the light you're with him. We appreciate that. We appreciate you. We appreciate you. If any of you all don't remember Richard or what he was all about, if you don't remember our father and who he was, take a look at Richard. Yeah. That's who he was. He was half Penix Jr. Mm-hmm. You look at him, you see Daddy all in him. He was so much like him too. Prankster? Yeah, he was a prankster. Like they were talking about, he had nicknames for everybody. That was Richard. My father was the same way. Richard was an all-around good guy. He really was. He was a good guy. I thank God he gave me the opportunity to see him right before we went on the other side. I thank God. He gave us the opportunity just to say goodbye to him. When I went to the hospital, you know, they wasn't even going to let us go in. But God works in mysterious ways. He works in mysterious ways. Brian wasn't there, and the lady came by and said, one of you all can go up. The rest of the sisters said, Dorothy, you go. Thank you, Lord. Mm-hmm. And I took my phone with me. That iPhone, heavy child, I don't know how it works. You know, I do a trial and error. But I said, let me see if I can take it for the rest of them to be able to see it. So I'm up there with the phone. I said, Tina, I don't know nothing about this phone. She said, Dorothy, let me do it for you. So she got that thing on Facebook, turned around, they were able to see him for the last time and say goodbye, we love you. Tell me God don't work things out.
Yes,
you tell me he don't work things out. He worked it right out. So they were able to say goodbye. I was able to say goodbye. I was able to speak to Richard. He understood what I was saying. I said, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I was so thankful. But I want to tell you about just a few little things about, we were living right down on the little bar down there. I'm the tomboy. I'm the one that ran with Thomas and Richard and Harold through the woods down there. I was the one climbing the trees with them. I'm the one up in the tree looking at them, trying to get her down the tree, Dorothy. I'm the tomboy, you know, I was the tomboy. I'm going to tell you just one little story about Richard because I want to keep this up here. When we were in elementary school, Richard's a year behind me. We were in elementary school. Miss Chris, down in front of the auditorium, said, Mr. Price, we have a little young man in my classroom who says he wants to be a minister when he grows up. I'm sitting in my seat. Oh, Lord. Please don't make me. Please don't. His name is Richard. Oh,
oh my Lord.
I want to go through the floor. Because he was such a prankster. I'm not Richard. But you know what? I was sitting there in the house today thinking, I said, you know, Lord, maybe that's what that was all about. Because we never know where we're going to go to before we leave the service, what we're going to be doing before we leave the service. Richard's sitting back in that room all this time, going through the things he's gone through in life, missing limbs, you know, taking one year, then missing some of his fingers. Mm-hmm. Do you know Richard never complained? I never heard him complain. I never heard him say he was feeling bad. He smiled every time he see me. Richard, I'm good. Never complained. We don't know what kind of services he was having back there in that room when he was back there by himself. But I can tell you this, and I believe it from my heart. I believe my brother was saved. I believe he was a saved man. And when he went out of here, when he preached his last sermon, when he went out of here,
going to heaven. Hello, everybody. I'm Richard's brother-in-law. God knows, I know 2 minutes couldn't be enough to talk about Richard. You know, Richard was a special person. He really was. And I thank God, you know, to have the honor just to be right here at the time that I'm here. You know, Richard was the kind of guy, you know, he would call me up and say, where you at? I tell him, he said, come on, let's go eat. I said, well, when he gonna take me in today? Richard come and get me, we got to go eat some chicken. We got to eat some chicken. The man though, it was just like he had a lung on him, so every chicken place to go. But Richard, I stay in Greensboro. Richard would take me some place. And I said, Richard, how you find out about this place? He said, man, it's chicken involved. I said, oh Lord, Richard. And the thing about it, everybody at the places that we went to knew Richard. And they treated him just like he did. I said, Richard, how many times you been in here, man? Man, this is why I come eat it. But it was so many places like that. You know, I thank God that I was a part of Richard's life. I really do, because he helped me so many ways. You know, I was incarcerated for a while, and Richard. God, no. Thank you. My wife would come and see me, and she would break down on the highway, come and see me. And she happened to never pick up the phone to call Richard. He said, I'll be right there. Amen. I could count on him. Never brought my mama to do that. I just thank God for him. I really do. He's really going to be missed. He's really going to be missed. You know, sometimes we don't spend enough time with the people that we love. You know, and then you say, I'm going to go by there. I'm going by there to see you. I'm going to come and see you, Richard. And I put it off. And the day that he passed away, I was right there on the street in Philadelphia, and I said, oh man, he had dialysis today. And I didn't go by. But I don't feel bad about that, because I know one thing about my God. He loves Richard so much more than I do. He loves him. And we go through things like this. You know, it's very few people that you know that you can't say nothing bad about. You know, we all have our own stories, and we all have been through some things. But I can't think of nothing bad about Richard. I can't think of nothing bad about him. One thing he ain't gonna do, he ain't gonna sit up and talk about nobody. He just was a genuine person. He was just a person that, you know, you ain't gonna run across too many people like Richard. You really ain't. And that's why I hold it an honor to be right here, being able to speak on his behalf, you know. I'm really gonna miss him. I'm really gonna miss him, and I know that God is in control. So I truly believe that God is doing the work right now. And I know we might not eat chicken on the other side. We're gonna eat something a little bit better on the other side. But I know I'm gonna be right there with him, because I know where he's going. You know, if we could say, well, he's going to heaven, but it's truly in our heart that we know who's really going to heaven. I know that Richard is going to heaven in my heart, and I know that I'm going to see him again. That's why it hurts my heart to see him go, but everybody got to come through this past, you know. I just married my son 3 months ago, and he was young. He was 20 or 39 years old. But I thank God that I was in my rightful place spiritually. Amen. Spiritually. I was in my rightful place with Richard spiritually, because I don't think I would have been able to do this had not my soul been right with Christ. I know I wouldn't. You know, had not God been carrying me through the way, I don't think I would have been able to do it. I just thank God that I got to know God. I got to know His Spirit. I got to know Richard, because I know about His Spirit. And I know His Spirit is well, well with God. You all keep us all in prayer.
Praise God, everybody. I thank God this evening, Jesus Christ, my Savior, Bishop Keller, my pastor Sanders Gill, and all the other pastors and members of the church. I thank God for the life Richard lived. I thank God for the love He showed me and my brothers and sisters, how He stood up for us down through the time. He was just a good guy, a big-hearted guy, you know. I love Richard. I love him to this day. I'd go by and see him sometime, and I'd have to lay that prayer on him. And he'd come back and say, thank you, Harry. I said, man, there ain't no problem. That's what I do. And I love Richard. I can think about some good times back in there. If I stay up here, I can stay up here all day long talking about some good times Mr. Richard and I, we had. But I'm going to take you back to where he was named. His name, Richard Pennington. Richard Henry Pennington. Named after our cousin, Richard Allen, cousin Q Mellon's husband.
And his Richard's middle name was Henry, named after our father. And that's where he got his name from. But some of his nieces and nephews may call him Uncle Richard. Some of them may call him good old Mr. Richard. Some of them may call him Brother Richard. And we all sometimes call him Big Richard, my big brother. We loved him. He had a heart full of gold. He had a good heart, a loving heart. Everywhere he'd go, he'd touch someone with his love. He'd been around a whole lot, too. He'd been around a lot of places. He went to Hattiesburg, Pennsylvania, stayed for a while. They loved him so much up there, they didn't want him to come back. He saw the need, he wanted to come back and see his brothers and sisters and his mother and father. So he migrated his way on back down to North Carolina. You can take the boy out of the country, but you can't take the country out of the boy. And that's what we read with Richard. I can remember some life-saving time we went through right down there in Hall Road down there. We had a hog pen across the road there from our house. And Richard told me, said, Harry, buddy, get on out of this house. You're staying here around these girls, you're going to get in trouble. I said, okay, let me get me a biscuit and a piece of meat, and I'll be on down there in a while. And so I come out the door. There him and Thomas were down at the hog pen. Playing with the hog, had a bag full of corn cob, throwing in the hog pen, and the hog stood about this tall right here. And they were throwing corn cob in the hog pen. One big hog was holding the other back trying to get the cob. So I said, what y'all doing? I jumped up on the side of there, and he said, I saw him throwing the cob in there, and I saw the pig was going. I said, give me one of them, Rich. So he gave me one, and I throw it over there, and I said, give me another. And I throw it over there, and I slipped over in the hog pen and fell. Every time I try to get up, I slip back down. I said, Richard, help me, man. Help me, man. Help me. He reached down, big old hand, grabbed me, pulled me up out of the side right there. I said, thank you, Richard. And here I go walking back up to the house, all messed up in hog crap, everything. Smelling all bad. Couldn't go in the house. I stopped right out there, a back porch back there. Now, we had a big old 50-gallon barrel of water right there. I couldn't go in the house and wash myself up, you know. And so I just got me a couple of about $3-4 and pulled them in the big old wash tub right there, right on the back porch. Took all my clothes off right there, got in the wash tub, got me some soap and stuff, and started washing stuff up. I couldn't go in the house where y'all were smelling that. That's what I was looking like, you know what I mean? Yeah. So I took my little, had a little bill of overhauls on, holes in the knee, people pay a whole lot for them packing like that now. So I got on the back porch, took all my clothes off, washed all up, got me another pair of pants, and I put them on, and left the other night on the porch. I didn't have to tell Mama, because the next week when she had to wash, she found out about it and said, what happened to these pants right here, Harry? Then I had to go back and explain to her what happened. That I was, Thomas and Richard was down there playing with the hog on the cone cobs in there, and I got up there and wanted to hang with her, and fell off over in there. She laughed about it and said, you had your punishment now. But I love Richard, and his big old hands. I feel like he grabbed my hand before them paws could get to me, because when I fell in and out, looked like they were warm holding under back trying to hit me. And I told him, I said, thank you, Richard. Thank you. And I always looked up to him for that purpose right there, and more purposes in life. I remember when we all moved out of Hall River and went on down there on Hooker Place and started farming down there, you know what I mean? And we had to, everybody had a chore around the house back then. If you weren't drawing water, you was busting wood. If you wasn't busting wood, you was washing dishes. You know, it was just a chore for everybody there. And so, on down there, we started getting out after we got our farm crop in. We started going helping around people, you know. Helping them in the back and make us a little bit of money, you know. And so we'd get out there, and I wanted to hang with the big boys, you know what I mean? Wasn't big as they were, but I wanted to hang with them. We'd be out there popping them leaves off like this right here, and Thomas and Richard, and they'd go on up and over here to me, because I was young, my arm wasn't that big to hold it, but it looked like Richard could hold a whole slide of back on his arm, you know what I mean? And, he'd look up, he'd look back, and come back and help me out. He had it in his heart. Ain't gonna leave no man behind. He came back and helped me up and get my rug, and maybe that next season, I was right there with him, crapping and popping right there along with him, slapping and popping right there along with him. I figured it wouldn't be long before I'd be right there with him. because we've been through so much in life, you know? And so, getting on down to the line right here, I remember when we had housed out the back, you know what I mean? And I'd get over Richard. Richard was like, he would be like that big giant. I'd send him to the line then. I said, "Rich man, will you go up in there and see if there's a snake up in there for you?" He had to fill out the bottom tier. I had to go all the way up to the top right there to fill out the top tier. I said, "Rich man, will you go up in there and check around in there and make sure those snake ain't up in there?" He said, "Yeah, I'll do it." I said, "So he went on up in there and showed up." I just got back from the barn, though, pretty good distance back. Oh, showed up, he come out with a big old black snake. Every year, before we put back in that barn, he'd go up in there and look around for that snake. And there was a big old snake. I'd get back and he'd try to run me with it. I said, "Please, just don't get in there. Please, man, please." He tried to kind of have a back stick in his hand. And I cracked him across the back. I said, "Please, just don't do that." I cracked him across the back of the back and stick. And I said, "I'm sorry, Rich. I told you not to do it. I told you not to do it because I'm scared of a snake. I don't care if it's a dead snake or a black snake. But I'm scared of him. I'm still scared of the name. If I ever run into all of them, I'm Richard, he was just a big old lion. And you go, king, and, you know, we're sending the lion then, you know, check things out. But I love Richard. I remember the times when we'd go up. As we went on down through life, he played basketball, and I was trying to get my driver's license to go to driver's ed school. And only so I could step out and get my driver's ed school, I had to have an adult to come back with me. And we didn't always have a ride to come back out to Hall River. So Richard finished his basketball practice, and I finished my driver's ed class, and we'd walk down Sprinkle Street uptown to Reva on the block. And waiting on some, trying to catch a ride back out to Hall River. Because everybody out here in Hall River knows we could catch a ride back, whether it be Buck Sellers or Brogan, any of them. They'd give us a ride back because they know what was up. But he watched over me that whole time we were making that transition right there. And I got a chance to go see him play basketball one time. They called him the beast. He could really take the bowl down. They called him IQ, eye for the shot, quick for the. Boom, you know, he's a bad man on the basketball court, but then getting on down the line, back in St. Pete, our house right there, and me and Richard had to stay together, you know, we were going to get something if we stay together. He didn't separate from me. He knew I was one of his younger brothers. He kept me at his grip. And he kept me out safe, out of danger. You know, people might, you know, there was a lot of bullies back then, but he didn't know bullies, you know, because I had Big Richard on the side. And so getting on down the line, I said, "Man, you had to get out of here just like I did. You been scared of him like that." That's all I got to say.
I believe Richard, the spirit of Richard is here somewhere out there. Laughter. Brenda and Ella Faye and Monet. We were the back of the down the chain. We were the youngest down there. And Derek. But they were supposed, Brenda, go ahead and give them a little fond memory. Yes. Yes. Ella Faye.
I'm not gonna say much, you know. I'll miss Richard. That's about, like I say, I miss him and I love him. We spent a lot of time together, but lately, and you know, I was there. I tried to be there for him because he'd always been there for us. He was that big brother. He protected us. He took care of us. And so I wanted to be there for him when he needed me. And I truly miss him. I didn't think I was gonna be able to make it up here. Let's just put it that way. But I did, and I'm thankful. The poem that I'm gonna read is the one called I Wish. In the program, I wish I knew how to say this. I wish the words would just come to mind. I wish I knew how to express to you how I wish I could just rewind. I wish I could just hear your voice
I wish I could just hear your laugh. I wish I was given the choice. You here with me is one wish I would have. I wish I could fight back the tears. I wish I could believe I would be okay. I wish I could just be strong and allow things to get better day by day. Truth is, I'm not that strong. My heart won't allow me to ignore. Your death has me wishing you would come back to me more and more. I know you are now in a joyful place. I know that your suffering has now lessened. I wish for the day I am by your side when we laugh together again in heaven. Thank you.
I want to thank the bishop for allowing all of us to get up and have words. You didn't have to do it, and we say thank you. You know, we've been together a long time, all of us, and to lose one is really hard. So thank you so much for allowing us to get up and have words. Now I got to do this. Now I'm going to do this, y'all. I've learned how to live holy, and I've learned how to live right. Yeah. troubles, all of my sickness, I won't have to cry no more. It will all be over when I
that he wanted him to be. He breathed the breath of life in him. And he became a living soul. And he put that man in the garden. And he said, everything is yours. But there's just one tree I need for you to leave alone. It's the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. He said, leave it alone. And everything else is yours. Man was perfect. His body was perfect. He was without eating defects and any flaws, anything. But man was placed in that situation because I read somewhere in a commentary that God wanted man to obey him and to love him and to look to him by choice. Hallelujah. Animals and all the birds and all those things, they didn't have a choice. They just had to do what God said. But God made man in his image. And he said, I want you to not be I don't want you to be just programmed, but I want you to love me so much that you will obey me, that you can receive all that I have for you. He said, leave that tree alone. And what happened? Man went to that tree.
Yeah.
And as soon as he ate of that tree, defects began to hit his body. That perfect body began to have flaws. As time went on, it would get worse and worse and worse. Y'all hear me? And ever since then, when man comes on this earth, he has that defective body. It gets worse and worse. Time brings about deterioration. But the Bible said that God so loved world, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever would believe in him should not perish but have everlasting life. I'm going faster because y'all, my cousins took up all the time. But I'm saved. Anybody here sitting here saved? I know I'm saved. I know where I'm going. I accepted Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, and with that comes the benefit of going to heaven when all this is over. But this body still is deteriorating. Still going down. Yeah. Getting old. Don't nobody say nothing. Getting old. Can't go like I used to.
Amen.
When I first got here a while ago, before everybody came, and the morticians and all were here, and I saw the front porch needed to be swept off, I went and got the broom and I was sweeping. And by the time I got through sweeping the porch, I was worn out. I said, I remember the time I could have swept 5 porches and it wouldn't have bothered me. Something's going on. But God so loved the world. You know, in the scriptures we find that there was others that was raised from the dead. What was it, Lazarus? He died. But Jesus went to his grave and called him and he came up. There was a widow's son that
He died. And he got him up. But don't you know that with even those, they had to die again. You know why? Because when that happened, Jesus had not gone and fulfilled all that was needed to be fulfilled. I'm about to get happy. That we would have eternal life. When Jesus hung on that cross, and his last, as he was saying his last words, when he was coming to the end, he said, "It is finished." He fixed it for us. He fixed it for all of us. All of us. And I am so glad because somebody told me about Jesus. I accepted Jesus Christ as my Savior. And even when this body has shut down, I got a new body waiting for me. Anybody know what I'm talking about? I got a new body waiting for me. I'm going to tell y'all something. This one looks good. You got to learn to encourage yourself. This one looks good. But there is a body that's waiting for me. Hallelujah. That puts rings around this body. And it will never deteriorate. It will never go down. It will never harm. It will never suffer. It will never age. It will be like God intended for it to be in the beginning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We can strut around here all day long if we want to, but your body is going down too. But when we all get to heaven, I'm going to get a new body. A new body that's not infected, that has no danger coming to it. It is well. It is holy. It's what God wants it to be. Anybody can get excited about what they're looking forward to. We got flaws. But I got a body waiting for me that is perfect. And I'm so glad that God loved us so much that he gave his son to pay the debt that we owed so that we wouldn't have to. So that we could get that new body and that we would live eternally. Hallelujah. I was talking to my husband one time. We were talking about this and I said, I can only imagine what my new body is going to look like.
Hallelujah.
He said, Felicia, your body looking good anyway? I said, because you got defective eyes. There is so much waiting for us.
Amen.
I will never deny that Jesus is the Christ.
Amen.
He is my everything. Amen. Heaven is my home. And when all this comes to a conclusion, I believe that he's going to give us another chance to take over this earth. Don't take over this earth and handle it the way God wants it. I mean, that's something to run over there and run around the church. I may not have as much as you have materially, but you can't outdo me when it comes to what God has in store for me. Amen. The stimulus checks ain't nothing compared to what God has in store. I'm glad I'm going to get a check. I just want to see if it had been deposited. And it had. But whether I get one or not, it is well with my soul. It is well with my soul. Anybody that's excited about what you got coming for you? It's exciting. Richard is going on to a better place. His body was shutting down. He was going through all this with his body. But God got a new body for him. Waiting for him. God got a new body. Waiting for me. Y'all. And with that said, there is a resurrected body. If you could select your own body, what kind would you choose? Would it be strong? Would it be athletic? Would it be beautiful? Paul explained that we will be recognized in our resurrected bodies. Yet they will be better than we can imagine, for they will be made to live forever. We will have our personal personalities and individualities, but these will be perfected through Christ's work. The Bible does not reveal everything that our resurrected bodies will be able to do, But we know that we will be perfect without sickness and disease. We got something to look forward to, y'all. Hallelujah. I'm so glad that somebody told me about Jesus. Now let us do something for somebody else and tell them about Jesus. So they'll have the same opportunity to get an awesome body that is waiting for us. And I guess that message was about the body because of what Richard's body had gone through. All of the different things that his body went through. Still able to smile, still able to cut up, but his body, it's over now. Perfection has taken place.
Amen.
It's Richard Penix.
Amen.
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 God bless you. I'm through. I know y'all clapping because I was short. That's all right.
Okay, guys. Just come in each other. See if y'all can step over these floors. Watch the step, okay?
And just put it on black mode.
Come around 50 feet.
Excuse me.
Siblings here.
You little fan, Thomas?
Because I got the numbers now.
Is there another family member that'd like to be seated?
But a short time to live, and is full of misery. He cometh up, and is cut down like a flower. He fleeth as it were a shadow, and never continueth in one stay. In the midst of life we are in death. Of whom may we seek for succor but of thee, O Lord, who for our sins art justly displeased? Yet, O Lord God, most holy, O Lord, most mighty, O holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us not into the bitter pains of eternal death. Thou knowest, Lord, the secrets of our hearts. Shut not thy merciful ears to our prayer, but spare us, Lord most holy, O God most mighty, O holy and merciful Savior. Thou most worthy judge eternal, suffer us not at our last hour for any pains of death to fall from thee. For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our deceased brother, we therefore commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth, and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, from henceforth blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Even so saith the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. Let us do the Lord's prayer together.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread,
and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
This time I'm going to ask Dr. Zandra Penix to come with our closing prayer, and then Pastor Thomas Penix will come with the benediction.
Thank you for the life of Uncle Richard, Lord. Thank you, God, most of all, for the life of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
His life, his death, his burial, and his resurrection.
Yes, Lord.
And because he was resurrected, we know that Uncle Richard will be resurrected.
Yes, Lord. Yes, yes.
Thank you, God, for restoring unto him his life, his land, God. Yes. Thank you, God.
You.
Thank you for this family, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for his wife, his children, Lord. Continue to strengthen them, Lord. Continue to wrap your loving arms around them, God. And let them know, God, that you'll never leave them. You'll never forsake them, God. So you'll be with them always, even until the end of the age, Lord. Continue to bless this family, Lord. Continue to allow us, God, to come together, stick together, and stay together, Lord. We love you, we praise you, we thank you. In Jesus' awesome name we pray. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, forever. Amen.
Amen.
This beautiful white dove is a symbol of joy, peace, and rest. For the psalmist said, oh, if I had wings like a dove, I'd fly away.
Amen.
Amen.
See you, Richard.
On behalf of Case Kennedy families, I think I'm sending thank Bishop Kellum, members of the Benasia Holy Church of God, the United States Navy, and I'm sorry, United States Army, friends and neighbors, all that's the kindness shown during the life and demise of a loved brother. We're now arrived at the conclusion of these services. Benedictions will now return to the cause. And thank you. God bless you all, and we love you. Thank you so much.